I'm Robbie Clevitt. Welcome back to the channel. Now, I've just cut this roof in. We're almost finished. The last job is to put on fascia and soffit. Now, this fascia and soffit is plastic. A lot of people use plastic now. Very low maintenance, instant finish, no painting. So I'm just gonna do the install and just show you a few tips and tricks that I've learned over the years, and it may help you. The tools I'll be using, obviously a spirit level, a square for cutting and marking. I've got a small disc cutter here with a very thin blade for metal. I've got poly pins and poly tops. These are the fixings, two different types. One's for the fascia, one's for the soffit. Now, what I like to do when I'm using plastic fascia is put some nice solid grounds all the way through, so that soffit is well supported. I can put my fixings through nice and equally. So instead of having them like different spacings, I can put them all nice and equally. And obviously a handsaw. So let's get on with it and let's get this job done. So what I like to do is have all of my material on the roof. I'll tack a couple of battens on, and all the battens are doing is just supporting it. But this is a nice place to keep the material flat whilst I'm working. So if you lay it out on your rafters, A, it keeps it flat, and B, you can work with it and cut it where you want it so it's nice and supported, because this stuff's quite floppy. Now, here's the first tip. If it's really cold, it has a tendency to snap if you're not careful, so make sure you handle it. If there's two of you, pass it up and hold it. I mean, it can be done on your own, but it's much better with two people. That's another tip for you. So my material is 5 meters long. This is pretty standard for you PVC fascias, etc. So I've got a building which is 1¼ length. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a full length all the way through, put my offcut in, put my joint strip on, but I'm also going to put a joint strip on the face of the fascia at the same position. So when you stand back and look at the building, it looks symmetrical. I just think that's a nicer detail than having just the one joint, especially on a single story where, you know, it's right in front of you. You've got a nice set of bifold doors. You want the fascia and everything to be symmetrical and match. What you don't want is this kind of like irregular joints. So these are the poly pins. So they've got a tiny little white head or a colored head, whatever color fascia and soffit you're using. And as I said before, what I like to do with my soffit, I've got grounds going all the way through. The rafters are spaced independently to sort of pick up a window, equal distance between each rafter, between windows, for example. So on the soffit, as you look up at it, what I'm gonna do, because I've got this nice solid fixing all the way through, is I'm gonna space all my nails at 500 centers all the way through. I'm also using on my square a couple of marks which indicate where I want my fixings. I'll just mark them on there. So 55 and 170. And then I can go through popping all the pins in. So when I lift the soffit up and in, they're already there. There's no faffing around trying to get the thing started, because working upside down, I've only got this much space. So I'll be kneeling up on these nice scaffold boards. And that's the best way I find to do it. So I'm gonna get on now, get all these nails through, turn it up, and get it fixed in. Thank you. keep your hands up, hold the middle up. So, once I put my first bit of soffit in, this is a soffit joining strip. Got a little bit of fascia here. The joints are going to go either end. But what I don't want to do is trap that with the fascia. I want it to be here, right on the end of the fascia, because otherwise it pulls the fascia down. The idea of this fascia is I've got it set up so it's going to come up nice and tight to here. So you've got a nice detail here. So to do that, I'll mark on the join how far it travels and I'll cut my strip to suit. So when I'm cutting all the trims and strips, the best thing I find is you can use a junior hacksaw, you can use a handsaw, but if you've got, you know, good space, you've got 8 teeth per inch is probably too many. What I like to use is an angle grinder with a very thin metal blade. I'll just do that for you. So one of these, basically this is just a sample piece. If I butt that in there and I can set this up. So I want to be here. And the beauty of this is it just cuts it real nice. It's a perfect finish, so it's ideal. And then we just slot these in the ends. And we carry on. So all the soffits on now, just a matter of putting the fascia on. The fascia is a lot easier. As I say, the way I've set this up is that my fascia with its overhang will come up tight to the soffit and give me the correct distance over the top for an over fascia vent and then the kick on the tiles. So I'm going to make myself a small device which is basically going to have some marks on it when I put the fascia in. This is going to hook over the top of the fascia and that is going to be exactly where I want my nails, and I'll slide it along, position my nails and bang it in. Yeah, that's it, put it up. Basically I want to choose exactly where my fixings go and use this as a guide. So I want to get into the top of the rafter and I want to get in at the bottom of the rafter above the soffit level. So that's my fixing points there. So I'll just slide this on everywhere and put a nail against, spike them home, and it's a nice neat job. Nice. Yeah. So once I've pinned up this, I'll get the other ends, get them ready, and then we'll put a level on everything and make sure it's absolutely spot on. Perfect. So a little tip for you, where I've got a butt join and I'm going to have a cover piece, what I like to do is fix behind the cover piece instead of trying to get all of these nails either side. You see that's going to get glued over there. So I take one of the smaller pins, take the head off on the in your hammer, and then we can basically fix that. Covered by the joint. So that's it, we're almost there. I have got one more cover strip to glue on, and you see I glue these with mitre fast. It's fine in the summer, and once it's bonded for good. In the winter I struggle a little bit with those. I quite like doing fascia and soffits, especially plastic in the summer. You don't get any of the issues with the cold. So it's a very straightforward install. I hope you found some of that useful. And I'll see you very soon.